Good morning, students. So our subject name is C programming for problem solving and subject code is 18 CPS 13, and the syllabus you can download from this link. There are two textbooks as per this syllabus. First textbook author name is Balaguruswamy and subject textbook name is programming in NC 7th edition from Tata McGraw Hill. And second textbook authors are Brian W. Cunningham and Dennis M. Ritchie. Textbook name is The C Programming Language from Prentice Hall of India. And the first module, it is divided into two parts. First part is Introduction to Computer Hardware and Software. Second part onwards, we are starting with our C Programming Language. So, first let us see what is Introduction to Computer Hardware and Software, what are the different types of software, so, and different computer generations, computer types, so, what is bit byte word, what are the components of computer, what is computer network, what are the devices which we require to make a computer network, and what is software, what are the different types of software, all these things we are seeing in the first part of the first module. So, let us start with what is computer. What is computer? We all know computer is a electronic device, right? It can accept input through input devices and process the input with the help of the CPU and produce the output with the help of the output device. That is computer. Take the input, process it and produce the output with the help of the input device, CPU and output device. That is computer. So, before going to say in the computer components in detail, let us see what is computer generations. There are five generations. From 1942 to 2020, there are five generations. First generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation and fifth generation. First generation is from 1940 to 1956. Second generation is from 1956 to 1963. Third generation is from 1964 to 1971. And fourth generation is from 1972 to 2010. And fifth generation or current generation is from 2010. And how it is different? How these generations are different? Why it is divided into five generations? That is basically based on the technology they used to make that computer. Based on that only, it is divided into five generations. So, first generation computer used vacuum tubes. Second generation computers used transistors. Third generation computers used integrated circuit. Fourth generation computers used microprocessors. And fifth generation onwards, they started to use artificial intelligence. So, let us see each generation in detail. So, going to first generation computer. First generation computer is a used vacuum tube technology, vacuum tubes, and it is very big size. Its size is very big, but we can store very less amount of information. And it was very much, that cost wise it was very high, and its work efficiency was very less. And there were those times there were no programming languages capabilities and all. So we were using punch cards to take the inputs. And energy consumption also it was very high and it was not reliable and constant maintenance were required. That is first generation computer. Going to second generation computer, they started to use transistors. And that is the first difference, transistors. And the inputs, the first generation computers taking input with the help of the punch card. But here we started to use assembly language along with the punch card to take the input. And here transistors are using, right? Because of that, we need cooling system. And maintenance like first generation computer, maintenance also required, constant maintenance required. And this second generation computer used only for specific purpose. And compared to first generation computer, second generation computer size wise it is less. But it can store more information compared to first generation. And speed also compared to first generation, it is faster. And energy consumption is less compared to first generation computer, and cost wise also it is better than first generation computer, and portability also better compared to first generation computer. Going to third generation computer, they started to use integrated circuit, and these IC chips are difficult to maintain and we need some sophisticated technology required for manufacturing IC, and air conditioners are required. That are the main disadvantages. Let us see what is advantages. Compared to first two generation, here size is very less. because we are using integrated circuits, right? Because of that, size is lesser, but we can store more information, and speed is better compared to second generation, and cost also like cost wise it is like less cost. And instead of punch card, they started to use keyboards and mouse for taking input, and they started to use the operating system for better resource management. And this from third generation onwards, the time sharing computers or multi programming and all came to the picture, and computational time also was very less. First two generations are like a microseconds computation time, second generation computers are like a microseconds, their computation time is like microseconds, but here it is nanoseconds. Coming to fourth generation computer, they started to use microprocessors, and graphic user interface technology was exploited to offer more comfort to the users. And here compared to third generation computer, it is far better for compared to speed, it is better, and size is very less, but we can store more information, and cost wise also it is less cost, less maintenance, energy consumption also less, and it is very fast. These are the advantages. Going to disadvantages, and this microprocessor design and fabrication is very complex. We need better technology, and we need like advanced technologies required, and air conditioning also required. And here all types of high level languages we started to use from the fourth generation. Coming to fifth generation, the main difference is we started to make use of artificial intelligence here. And this generation is based on ULSI technology. What is ULSI technology? It is ultra large scale integration technology. And it is far, speed wise is very high speed, cost is less, and we can store large amount of data, and your machine size is very small, and it has different features are there. And the disadvantages is they need very low level languages, and they make human brain dull and domed because we are using artificial intelligence. These are the five different generations of computers. Based on the technology we are using, computers that period is divided into five generations. First generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, fifth generation. From 1940 to 2020. And next topic is computer types. Computer you can classified into different based on different characteristics, like based on type you can classify your computer, based on size you can classify your computer, based on purpose also you can classify your computer. So if you classify the computer based on purpose, there are two types: general purpose computer and special purpose computer. General purpose computer are like whatever we have, that is general purpose computers, and special purpose computer example is NASA is using special purpose computers. And based on type, there are three different types of computers. Analog computers are there, digital computers are there, hybrid computers are there. What is analog computer? Analog computers are like they are using, or that computer inputs are analog inputs. Analog input means a continuous input. We cannot take the discrete values. The inputs are continuous input, like a speed or temperature. These all are the inputs. It is continuous values, right? We cannot take the particular one. That discrete values are not available. It is continuous one. For example, thermometers or speedometer. These all are machines are example for analog computers. And the second one is digital computer. Digital computer are taking digits or binaries, binary inputs. That is digital computer, and these inputs are processing with the help of the programming languages. And our computer, our laptop, our desktops are example for digital computers. Next one is hybrid. Hybrid computer can take both analog and digital inputs. Examples are in a petrol pump, we are using some kind of machines, right? That is example for analog and hybrid machines. They can take both analog inputs and digital inputs. Or the machine which we use in aeroplane, also example for hybrid computers. And based on size also you can divide your classify your computers. Micro computers are there, mini computers are there, mainframe computers are there, super computers are there. Micro computers are like it is a single user computer, and there we are using one microprocessor. Mini computers are not single user, it is multiple user computers. At a time it can support hundreds of users. Coming to mainframe, it is also multi user computer, but it can support thousands of users at a time simultaneously. The main difference between the mini computer and mainframe computer is the software technology which we are using. That is the main difference. Coming to supercomputer, it is extremely fast. Supercomputers are like a it is extremely high speed computers, and it can support or millions of instructions per second, hundreds of millions of instructions per second. That is supercomputers. I hope you all understood different types of computers. Based on size, we can divide the computers into microcomputer, mini computer, mainframe computer, and supercomputer. Based on purpose also, you can divide. It is general purpose computer and special purpose computer. General purpose computers are our computers. Special purpose computers are used only for that particular purpose. NASA using special purpose computers, right? And based on type also, we can divide. Like analog type computer, digital computers are there. Hybrid computers are there. Analog computer are taking analog inputs. Now, like a speedometer, thermometer are taking analog input inputs, right? Analog input means a continuous input. They are not taking care of. It's not possible to give discrete values. That is analog computers. Digital computers are taking digital inputs, like digits or binary inputs, right? And that inputs are processed in the form with the help of programming languages. Our laptop or our desktop is example for. Digital computers, and hybrid computer can take both analog input and digital input. Example is the machine which we used in aeroplane or petrol pumps. I hope all of you understood this topic. Thank you all.